Oh, the pitter patter of rain on the motorhome roof. Oh, how depressing. but it is January in England, isn't it? So basically, yeah, we're kind of like back from our epic trip. We had an amazing time, guys. I hope you've been like, if you've been like following our videos on the trip, I did my sort of best to try and keep it going, keep the exactly what we're doing. It's a lot of hard work, but I just like to do that if I possibly can. So I hope you've been watching and enjoying it. Thank you for watching if you have. Anyway, in the meantime, so it's a bit of like the aftermath of our trip now. It's 1 week later. We would have been this time getting ready to board at Calais and come back into England. But I actually got home in Devon at 6:15 on Sunday night. So it was literally park the motorhome up, empty a few laundry, the remainder of our little bits of food that we had left over, a few odds and ends, back into our house and get ready for work on Monday morning. So anyway, I'm literally back to work, and then it's like dark in the mornings, dark at night, just recuperating, catching up on a few videos that I missed on the trip. That might be informative to you guys, it's Sunday again, so I've got a few little bits and pieces to sort out, the reason I literally woke up this morning, I'm sort of like lying in bed, and we're literally scrolling through a bit of Facebook, as you do on a Sunday morning when it's peeing down the rain, I just sort of like stumbled across, I did see it yesterday actually, the start of the thread of someone saying about Baltic Wharf, Caravan and Motorhome Club site, on the price there, and how they were sort of like, it was a bit sort of £50, and we were, you know, me and Caroline were just sort of saying that basically if you wanna stay in the heart of Bristol and have that city camp kind of vibe right on the doorstep of everything going on, accommodation, safe, secure accommodation in Bristol. That's our kind of view, if you want to go there. And, you know, we know that basically it's shut. I think it's, it's been shut in. How long has it been shut in? We did a video there nearly a year ago now. We did some, we went up there and stayed there, and it was like lovely. We really enjoyed it around the water's edge, the SS Great Britain, all that kind of stuff. There's a good vibe there, and plenty going on, plenty to see. And maybe this year might be the last time, who knows? I don't know how, so it's due to move after that rain. So that was that little bit. I come back into England, and so Monday morning, you know, so yeah, we always have this discussion when we're driving from Dover to Devon. It can be a bit of a drag. It's kind of like, especially when you're on your way home. When you're actually going, it doesn't feel so bad. But when you're coming back, it's always sometimes a bit of a drag. The new Greggs for a sausage roll with Lael services up near Andover is one little goal we go for. So you're always up for a Greggs sausage roll on the way home. Monday morning, I'm kind of like, yeah, okay, let's have a little look, because we have this session. Maybe we should go down and use our local port of Plymouth, maybe, and go across to France. So I started having a little dive around at some of the Brittany ferries, and I'm not that £50 at Baltic Wharf. I'm not actually, I sort of do this little comparison. So there was people there want to go and stay for a week at Baltic Wharf, and fair play to you, you know what I mean? You know, there's shed loads to do for a week up there. So I'm kind of like looking at some ferry prices, and me from here to go to Plymouth, this rain is horrible. For me to go to Plymouth, I've got about a 40-minute drive. So on the other hand, I could go to Poole, Cherbourg. Okay, let's have a quick look at that one then. So that for me is 2 hours. So Yeah, a little bit. But so the cruise from Plymouth to Roscoff is overnight. I may need a reclining seat. You've got to book a seat and stuff. I haven't done it for a long time, actually. The last time we went over was on a motorbike. So I haven't done it for a long time. And with the motorhome, I haven't actually done it. We've always done it with motorbikes. So yeah, so then I kind of like, okay, so you've got to book a maybe a cabin there, a reclining chair, because it's an overnighter. So okay, the pool is a 4.5 hour cruise. That suits me better, because I don't like staying on boats too long. I like to be like driving or and seeing scenery and stuff, you know. So although I don't like the M3 and the M25, that isn't the scenery I like. But yeah, so I kind of like, hello, let's have a comparison then. So I'm just gonna literally chuck up a couple of screenshots that I took. The first one is obviously gonna be the Plymouth, let me just double check. So the Plymouth one was coming in at 100. These are one way. These are one way prices. So £189 leave at 10 o'clock at night and arrive in France, Roscoff at 8 o'clock in the morning. So okay. And then on top of that, I'd have to book a cabin or a seat, which adds a little bit more. I have got a discount code that I applied to this that I've had for a long time. So it gives you a little bit of a discount off these prices, on these prices. So anyway, then going across to the Paul Cherbourg was coming in at 153. These are, so that's economy. And that's leaving at 8:30 in the morning and arriving at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So I'm like, okay, that's pretty nice, isn't it? So then I thought, well, I'll just throw up this example of a camper stopler. I'm not saying I'm going to this particular one, but I'm just going to throw it up there, and then I'm going to scroll down so it gives you the location and the bit of information. And it looks like 750 euros per night, and so there's some reviews on it. Very friendly reception, beautiful marked out spacious pitches, with or without electricity or without shade, everything well serviced, this, that, and the other. A few more, like €6 overnight stay, including discharge of water. Yeah, so at the end of the day, on the bottom there it says like chemical toilet, waste free, dogs allowed, electricity free. So there you go. So there's a couple of you know, I just sort of do these comparisons. So obviously I know you've got that crossing and that is a one-way crossing, but like when you get the other side, it's not a million miles away. So I had someone actually message me this week as well about Bruges, where I put the Bruges up, and they said they've always like fancied going to Bruges, but are a bit sort of so go to Bruges. These kind of little, if you've got that little inclination, it's I don't know what people driving on the other side of the road, possibly, it's easy. I said to Caroline, when we came back into England and we're coming back up the motorway, and I was kind of like we've been driving 2,000 miles, we've driven 2,000 miles, and then literally you just get back on the English motorway and it's, you don't even bat an eyelid, you know. I find it quite easy driving abroad, the roundabouts, we've sort of talked about this before. So anyway, that was one little thing. So I've straight away got maybe a little artillery ticking away in maybe Normandy, sort of like infiltration a bit of Normandy, and try and get some good vlogs from out there. So haven't totally decided what we're going to do yet, but that is one possibility, and that looks quite attractive for me, and it's going to save me that 4.5 hours driving all the way to Dover and then 4.5 hours back on a good run. That's a really good run. So there we go. That's, I'm just going to put that out there Sunday morning. Yeah, what else have I got? Oh, and not only that, right, okay, so I've still fresh off the boat, big box of duty free. So on the way back, we actually picked up, so this is the bonus, one of the bonuses of obviously going on the ferry, on the Eurotunnel, to get a bit of duty free. And so the litre bottles of this Kraken rum were coming in at £12.69. This is a big bowl, it's a litre. Saving, if you like drinking. So anyway, the next one would be the oldies. So we had a couple of Caroline has a gin, so a couple of litre bottles of Whitley Neal, and so you get two of these for £30 on the duty free. Okay, so I've still got the receipt in my hand. So basically, she's got rhubarb and ginger, and I don't know, like I say, this is still in the box, and this is the blackberry 1 litre bottle. So bonus of traveling. So if you're going to Baltic Wharf and you've got to go into Tesco's and pick up your gin and your rum, yeah, okay, so I'm a little saving. So if you're going to drink it, we're only allowed on the way out, it's only 1 litre of mine, so but in a motorhome there's plenty of places. No, I don't say that. The thing I'm just sorting out is a few of my books. So on trips you pick up books, anything of interest that you might spot, and yes, it's little things like this. So for future reference, Salzburg, when we were in Salzburg, there was a salt mine there, there is a Porsche museum that is pretty good, there is a KTM motorcycle hall there that you can contact and view. What's this all about? Stiegel brewery tour, maybe. Yeah, looked a bit sort of quite interesting. So I pick up information. We've still got the auto camp Troska from Prague. We have champagne from this guy down in Epernay. We have Berg Hohenzollern. So that's where we were Christmas Day. Borden map, Euro Park Christmas market thing. Guys, check out our channel and check out some of the amazing stuff that we've seen, and it might just give you a little bit of inspiration maybe to this is Salzburg Christmas market, actually. This one here, look, this is a Salzburg one that I picked up. But what a place to go to Salzburg next year for Christmas. It's awesome. Go to Borden for Borden. We were there on Christmas Eve. Borden was outrageous. So yeah, and a few Swiss books I think that found of interest that we're going to have a little peruse through at a later date. So that's what I do on my Sunday morning. Yeah, pick up all the paperwork, see what we got lying around. So we had a couple of deliveries while we're away. I had these I don't know if you guys seen where we did a little blog for Fitville on Caroline's trainers. Well, I was hoping to get these trainers actually before we went, which it didn't happen, but they are in the box when I got back and they're waiting for me. So I was hoping that these were going to come, because I was looking for some like comfortable like training shoes sort of thing like this for the driving. So it makes it nice and cut, and then when if you've got to like jump out and get fuel and stuff, it's just something nice to bounce around in, nothing too hectic. But yeah, just basically for like driving. So these are Fitville company. We're going to I've got a really good discount. These are not over the top expensive, okay? So basically we've got a discount code as well. There is their little pamphlet in there, how to love your feet. Look, let's have a little look. So yeah, and I've literally gonna check these out and give them a little bit of a road test. Yeah, there's plenty of information there. If you're in line for some shoes, have a look at their website. They've got loads on their website. Okay, well, I'll tell you what, look, I'm just gonna actually put that Fitville trainer on my foot and see. Oh, not bad. Yeah. So these, they're like wide. I've got quite a wide foot actually. It's cool. If you haven't got nothing better to do on Sunday and you want a pair of trainers and want to get a bit of a discount on a pair of trainers for this spring to spring around in, check out their website. And I'm going to put the link to the website in the description box. And we've got this, like I say, they've sent us a promo code. You know what I mean? We're put out there. You guys are giving us a promo code for our YouTube subscribers, our viewers. Let's get it on. Let's give them some discount as well. So how about that? That's not bad. So that's about it, guys, really. That is it, I think, until I've got something else to babble on about later on in the week. I'll take you. So if this trip for me, this Normandy thing starts to peel off, I'll keep you updated on that. And I haven't finalized any dates just yet, but I'm going to keep an eye on that one. I'm quite excited about it. We did a motorbike trip there a few years ago, and great memories of visiting Omaha Beach, Aramonch down there. Hey, and if you guys have got any pointers for me to go and have a look at, let me know. Someone was actually telling me, I was talking to someone this week, and they were telling me about the London gun that the Germans were trying to made this super gun that was situated underground. And it's then kind of like stories that, some of them stories you don't know much about and don't hear much about. I never even knew anything about it. that's just another story. And I've just got this Band of, I love my Band of, Band of Brothers. In the winter, you sit there and watch Band of Brothers and you just like evaporate into that D-Day and what them guys went through. And I'm kind of like, maybe that's the destination for Joffy to go and get down on Omaha Beach, get the feeling. I'm gonna leave it there. I'm just drifting away. My mind is drifting away already, like, on that one. Drifting away already. And I've got a good feeling. I've got a good feeling about that trip, and I think it's gonna be pretty monumental. Right, I'm going to leave it there, guys. Thanks for watching this video, and always give me a comment. Send me a comment. Any recommendations for like Normandy area? Any recommendations that you need from me on our recent trip? Go to Salzburg, Prague, Baden-Baden. We had an amazing time up in them Austrian mountains, Switzerland. People were going to probably like say, what did it cost? Everybody's like, what did it cost you, Joff? And our biggest expenditure, guys, was the fuel cost. Obviously, that's a major contributor. But like I always say before, book a plane ticket to America and it will cost you £800 to £1,000. We had an incredible time, 17 nights of, and relatively, we had 2 nights in Switzerland. We 5 Swiss francs, it can be done. Do you know what I mean? And we had some slightly more expensive, but yeah, Salzburg. The place was, I'm babbling. Leave it there. Send me a message. Bye for now. Just before I go, little bonus, little throw in. My fridge is open, getting aired. It's totally empty except for a few bottles of Coke in the bottom. But anyway, another thing just before I go, one of the biggest things again for us, that fridge. If you want one of them fridges, I'm going to put the link in again to this video, the fridge in the back that we fill up. I came back with scampi, chicken, and one tagliatelle ready meal that was in the fridge that we didn't get around to. But apart from that, I think we had four meals out. So we cooked our food all, you know, the rest of the trip was we were cooking our food. That makes your trip economical. We've been eating that kind of food at home anyway. So the fridge in the back of this motorhome, you know what we've got. Smart Ice fridge from Suzy. I'm gonna chuck her link in. If you're in the market this year, 2023, for one of them fridges, go to her website, give her a ring. She will give you a really good price if you mention Mo Hotel Adventures. Okay, that's it for me. I'm gone. Bye.